Hi, and welcome to yet another new episode of Azure Vlog, the fourth episode. In this episode, I will talk about Azure networking, especially on how to set up Azure networking on the right way. First, we'll have a look at some basic topics, basic networking. Later on, we will talk about the more advanced stuff, like your hybrid VPN connection, express route, and security. First topic, basic networking. Basic networking actually starts with a subscription. Within that subscription, we're going to build a resource group, and in that resource group, we're going to build our VNet, a virtual network. Please choose the name of your resource group wisely. What is also interesting to mention over here is that we can use resource groups for RBAC, role-based access control. We can make sure that our network administrator only has access to the resource group which hold the network resources, for example, the virtual network. Now that our resource group is in place, it's time to create the virtual network. Choose the name of your virtual network wisely. When creating your virtual network in Azure, make sure that you're not using address space that overlaps with the address space you're using in your on-premise network. When you want to set up a connection between your Azure virtual network and your on-premise network, it's not allowed to have overlap in it. During the creation of our VNet, we also have to define the first subnet. It's really interesting to think about your subnetting on forehand. For example, do you want to have a DMZ zone, an application zone, or a specific zone which you can use for example, your database servers, a data zone. Right after defining and creating our subnets, it's time to put the network security groups, also known as NSGs, in place. When you define your NSG, make sure that all traffic is denied. Only allow for traffic that's required for your service. By doing that, you're also going for the most secure environment. By default, you block everything and you only allow traffic for the services that you require. So, no unneeded ports are opened. So, the VNet is in place. Our NSGs are okay. We have the first VM running in Azure, so it's time to make a hybrid connection. So we have two flavors to connect our Azure network to our on-premise network. One that's via VPN, and the other is via ExpressRoute. With the VPN, we have two types of connection. A point-to-site connection, that's why we connect our laptop or computer directly to the Azure virtual network, or a site-to-site connection. And that's where we connect our complete on-premise network to our Azure VNet. To get started with the hybrid connection, we have to deploy a virtual network gateway. We can easily deploy a network gateway via the Azure portal or via PowerShell. It's important to have the virtual network gateway in the same resource group as where we have our VNet. Remember, role-based access control. Our network administrator is now able to manage the virtual network gateway and the VNet since it's living in the same resource group. When deploying the virtual network gateway, we have to define the type of gateway. We can choose for ExpressRoute or we can choose for VPN. In this demonstration, I will go for VPN. Next to the gateway type, we have to define the VPN type. We can choose between policy-based or between route-based. Route-based actually means dynamic routing, and policy-based means static routing. For this simple demonstration, I will go for policy-based, also known as static routing. Next, we have to define the virtual network in which we want to have our virtual network gateway, and we also have to assign a public IP address to the gateway. The public IP address is the IP address that is used for communication between the gateway and your on-premise network gateway. After deploying the virtual network gateway, we have to deploy what's called a local gateway. The local gateway resource in Azure actually represents your on-premise router. We have to define a name, its IP address, and the address space that the router represents. Just like the other network resources, we put it in the same resource group as where we have our VNet living. So, now our virtual gateway is in place and our local gateway is in place, it's time to create the connection. The connection between the local router that is living on-premise and the virtual network gateway that's living in Azure. We do that by going to our virtual network gateway, click on connections and create a connection over there. When creating the connection, we can choose between three connection types: Express Route, as VNet to VNet, which is also known as VNet peering, and VPN side to side. To create a VPN side to side connection, well, you guess it, we have to go for the VPN option in the list. Now your Azure Virtual Network is ready to communicate with your on-premise precious network. Of course, you have to configure your on-premise router. But since there are a lot of vendors and a lot of types of routers, I recommend going to your vendor for a manual how to configure a VPN connection in your router. In most cases, the side-to-side VPN connection is really suitable. But when you want to go big, I think you have to go for ExpressRoute. As I mentioned earlier, we have ExpressRoute in three types. One, that's the public peering. That's where we connect our on-premise network directly to the Microsoft Azure public services. Think of web apps, databases, VSTS, etc. We have Microsoft peering, which connects your on-premise network directly to Office 365. And last but not least, we have private peering. This is where we connect your on-premise network directly into your Azure virtual network. ExpressRoute can be delivered to you in two ways. One, that's via a cloud exchange provider, for example, Equinix. Equinix is a data center where you can have a connection directly to Microsoft. The other one is via a service provider. The service provider is routing the ExpressRoute connection directly to your office or data center. The great thing about the ExpressRoute is that it's your direct connection, so latency is very low. When you compare it with the side-to-side VPN connection, the VPN connection is going over the internet. Since it's going over the internet, the latency is unpredictable. And with that, I would like to close this Azure vlog. Please check the description for some links to documentation regarding the topics that were in this Azure vlog. If you found this really interesting, please hit the thumbs up button and also subscribe to this channel. Thank you very much and see you next time.